What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I hope that you're having a lovely day. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to, excuse me if I mispronounced the name, Pekka Pohjola, with his song The Mathematician's Air Display. This is off of his album of the same name, his third album, released in 1977. So we most recently listened to Pekka from Wigwam, as he was playing there. I've had the name continuously stuck in my mind, and a lot of you guys had also mentioned him in relation to one of my favorite artists of recent times, Mike Oldfield. Because apparently, Mike Oldfield plays guitar throughout this whole album. So, that's an immediate draw for me. Now, even before Wigwam, and I believe I've mentioned it there before, but I'm familiar with Pekka's song, The Madness Subsides, because that song was sampled and used in DJ Shadow's song, Midnight in a Perfect World. Which, by the way, I think that is one of the coolest and most underrated things about music, specifically like generational. I'm familiar with that song because of DJ Shadow, who made one of the most inspiring, beautiful pieces of music and one of the best albums and most influential albums in all of instrumental hip-hop. And of course, the sample and the way he uses Pekka's music in that song is so beautiful, and which leads me, and apparently a lot of other people, to look at the original, which is just a great song on its own. I don't know, music can cross barriers and music can lead you down roads that you never thought that you'd be led down. Kind of like the reason I'm doing this channel, you know? I'm being led down so many roads I would have never thought of even, like, existed, let alone traveled. But thanks to you guys, we are traveling together. So anyways, I figured we'd listen to the title track off of his album and see where we go from there. It was not available on Spotify, so I'm using YouTube. And if you haven't, please listen to his song, The Madness Subsides. And after you listen to that song, listen to DJ Shadow, Midnight in a Perfect World. It's just so beautiful. It's just so good. Anyways, you can join me on Twitter in the comments down below. I hope that you're having a lovely day. And let's do it. This is Pekka Pohjola with Mathematician's Air Display. We'll be right back. I was actually looking at the end and I was watching that little red line get towards the end, and I really did not want this song to end. That was intense. What'd you guys think? I thought that was intense. So one, I didn't expect for the climax of the song to last for like half of the song, and every time that I thought it would break down, it would just keep on ramping up. And I mean, Mike Oldfield, his guitar work is very noticeable. It's his very unique style of guitar playing. It even has this unique style of drama, right? And merged so well with Pekka's bass playing. I like Pekka's playing because, yes, sometimes he's going to stand out. I mean, listen, it's this is his album, right? He should stand out. But he doesn't stand out the way that, like, a bass player making a solo album would maybe typically stand out. Yes, he's going to show you some flashy riffs, he's going to give you some tasty licks, but at the end of the day, he's also going to provide that rhythmic and melodic balance to the song where it's needed. This song had a lot of weight, a lot of drama about it, I would say especially because of the keyboards and because of Mike Oldfield. That's where like that big drama comes in. But then like the drumming had a huge swing to it, carrying a lot of the momentum and a lot of the structure changes as well. Because, I mean, in some of those big crashing moments in that climax, the drums are like, they're not double kicking at points, but I mean, they're going heavy. They're thrashing a little bit. And there's so many cool breakdowns within just the drums if you listen. At a certain point, the music kind of becomes a cacophony, at least to me, right? It's just like crashing and flashing everywhere. But if you just listen specifically to the drumming, like he is grooving out on there. He makes me jealous. He makes me want to hop on the drums and play. And I couldn't play that well, but it makes me want to try regardless. But wow, this was really good. Pierre Morland from Gong, and who's played with Mike Oldfield, is playing the drums on this track. And he once again proves himself in his intensity as he's going. In case you didn't know anything about Pekka, and like I said, I'm sorry if I mispronounced the name, but he's playing bass. As I mentioned, he's also playing piano, synthesizers. His synthesizer work alongside with Mike's guitar just adds such a huge mountain slide of melody in this song. I mean, it's really powerful. One thing I don't like about YouTube and using YouTube for music is sometimes the music isn't as clear, and I feel like perhaps this wasn't as clear to myself. I would like to listen to it like proper because there's a lot going on, and I feel like maybe it's just a little compressed, but you know, that's more of YouTube side of things, not, you know, Pekka's side of things. I like this really big, weighty swing that they have going on here. And this fun little rhythm that builds up. It's somewhat circus-like, which when I'm looking at the title of the song, The Mathematician's Air Display, I don't know if I'm thinking of a circus necessarily, but I'm thinking of like an air display, perhaps like trick planes and, or maybe like somersaults and gymnastics of some sort. Maybe it is some sort of trapeze act, right? And then I see The Mathematician's Air Display. So I imagine him calculating out all the physics of doing these tricks and performing for the audience. As the audience, we sit back, wowed and amazed at what's going on, this display that's going on in front of us. And I just think that this is like a really fun way to kind of bring that in. Right? Like this reins it in, gets you back into the swing. And it's interesting how they begin with this. And then even as the song picks up into its more momentous parts, it still retains that swing. It still brings it down at certain levels, so that it can build itself back up. And when it builds itself back up, at some point, it becomes like the juggernaut. It just doesn't stop. See, like the beautiful bass playing here, with the echo of, is that guitar maybe? This is just very melodic. It feels very summertime to me. Like, his bass tone's very warm, it's very playful. Like, it just hits all the right notes. There goes Mike. Here's our first, like, quick hit of drama. That is groovy. Now, can I tell you something? Listening to the drums by Pierre, it actually reminded me of the drum playing by Barlow from Jethro Tull. There's just a certain kind of swing that he has. I don't know if there's any relation or not, but something about the drumming specifically is just reminding me of Barlow's drumming in Jethro Tull. Maybe that's just because I've been listening to them recently, and for some reason this is hitting the same notes. I don't know. Listen to this little speedy buildup we got going on. Ooh, I love those hi-hat hits. Those are so clear and crisp. And then slowly this really, really builds up. And this is where the song begins to, like, not stop. This is a steam engine that is totally out of control. The brakes, they've been cut. The coal, burning hot. Hey, that is awesome. And those strings from the synths just rising alongside with it, just doubling all these melodies. I mean, it's just sugar. And it just keeps on repeating in this cycle of intensity. And then, hold on, let me let it go, because Mike is about to scream. And then they use that melody to bring it back down. Like, this is a really good song. I wish it was on Spotify so I could toss it on my playlist, but... And you get a little last taste of bass here at the end with those sweet, sweet synths as well. That's fun. One of the coolest parts in this is the shift. You can play it back again. Fast tempo. Bring it right back down. That is so cool. Yeah, this song has it all. I like it. Tell me what you guys thought, though. You can join me on Twitter in the comments down below. You can support the channel on Patreon if you want. But otherwise, just thank you for being here. Hope you enjoyed the music. Hope you enjoyed the video. And I hope that you have a great night. Bye.